In this 7-step Photoshop tutorial, I will walk through step-by-step how to create this awesome baseball card graphic for social media. The first step is to create our canvas by going up to File, New, and then you can pause the screen and use these same settings. Now, drag your team's logo across the canvas and make it cover the entire screen. Let's head up to Filter and go to Camera Raw Filter. We're going to make our background layer look a little bit grainy, so increase the grain slider inside of Photoshop's Camera Raw Filter. Press OK and you should have something that looks like this. Let's add our main player image to the edit. We can create a fading effect inside of Photoshop by selecting our mask and then painting with the black paintbrush. Head back up to Camera Raw Filter and we're going to go make an adjustment to our player's skin. First, in order to match the background, add some grain onto our player. Next, take down the shadows, increase the contrast, clarity, as well as texture. This will help to create that detailed looking skin that you see in professional designers' posts. I also decided to add a little vibrance for an enhanced color feel. We can now drag in our last player image. I recommend using a full body shot of a player. You will see why I say this later in the video. Press Command J with your player layer selected to duplicate your layer. Then go up to Image Adjustments and select Hue and Saturation. What you want to do is reduce the lightness for the duplicated player layer so that it looks like this. Right click on the black player layer and convert it to a smart object. Now you can right click as a smart object and that gives you the capability to flip it horizontal or vertical. The next step is to go up to Filter, Blur, and add a Gaussian blur. If you move the slider to the right, it creates more of a blur. If you move it to the left, it creates less of a blur. Let's now create a layer mask and then with a soft brush, we're going to erase the bottom part of our shadow. You can do this until you get something that looks like this. This doesn't look bad, but we aren't done creating our shadow. Add a new layer below our player image and adjust the size of our brush so that it is thinner. And then we can put another shadow directly below our player. Insert three logos to fill the spaces in the corners and directly below your player. These can be anything, but for this graphic, I want it to look like a baseball card, so I'm going to use the Topps logo. This is one of my favorite tips. So if you have a logo that blends into your background, go up to Image Adjustments and then Hue and Saturation. If you increase the lightness, it turns the logo white. If you decrease the lightness, it's going to turn it black. Now throw in your first name of the player that you're going to be using the graphic for. We're going to add a drop shadow to this text layer. We're going to make a couple other adjustments within the drop shadow effects, so follow along closely. Next, take the rectangle tool and create a rectangle right under your player's first name. You can change the color by going up to Fill and then selecting the color wheel. From there, you can choose whatever color your logo is. And in my case, I just sampled the background to get this blue color. Now, insert another text layer, and this is going to be your player's last name. A personal preference of mine is to add a shadow behind the player in order to tie everything together. This can be done by creating a layer below your player image and above your text layer. And then you can just paint back on with a black brush with a low hardness level. All right, this is where things get a little confusing, so stick with me here. Select your top layer, hold shift, and scroll down to the very bottom layer. Click on this layer, and this will select all the layers we have created to this point. We're gonna right click and duplicate all of these layers. Click the folder button in order to put all of these layers into a group. We're going to go back into that group and we're going to select the top layer, hold shift, select the bottom layer, and we're going to convert this all into one smart object. Okay, drag in a baseball card, select the marquee tool, and drag it to where your baseball card is going to go. Once you have a selection, hit the mask button and it's going to cut out only your selection. But we want the outer portion of the card. So if you hit Command I on the layer mask, it's going to invert your mask. You can readjust the smart object layer in order to fit inside the baseball card. Originally, it's going to be too large for the card, which isn't a problem at all. Hit the mask button and go back to the marquee tool and then select the outside portion of your poster design. Select the paintbrush tool and then you can erase the outside portion of your design. It is important that you're painting with the black paintbrush, because if you're using the white paintbrush, it's not going to erase anything. If you guys are looking to use this template for your sports program, you can head over to my Patreon where you can download the PSD. I give away a graphics pack every single month, as well as the PSD templates for all of my videos that I drop on YouTube. So you guys aren't going to want to miss out on that. We're almost to the best part of the design, so stick with me here. The next step is to blur the background. It's a pretty simple step. Select all of your layers like we learned how to do earlier. Merge all of your layers together, and then you can see it has become one background layer. Go up to Filter, Blur, and then Gaussian Blur. This will blur the background and shift your viewer's focus to the middle portion of the sports poster design. You can tilt the baseball card, and also I love adding a color lookup called Fuji 2395. You can do this by hitting the new adjustment button, going to color lookup, and then selecting Fuji. The best part about this entire Photoshop edit is how interchangeable it is. If you double click on your smart object layer, you can go into the design and then make any changes that you want. For example, if I wanted to get rid of the player layer right here, all I would have to do is hit the X here and then hit save, and our player layer is going to be gone inside the main design. If you guys like this video, drop a like for me and check out some of my other design videos. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video.